Hello and good morning, everyone. I'm Michael Cook, Chief of the Public Information Office at the U.S. Census Bureau. We have an exciting day ahead of us today that includes special guests from Sesame Street and Cat in the Hat. The 2020 Census is officially here. The Census is a massive undertaking, and we are thrilled to be here at the Great Lakes Science Center with all of you and some of our partners. Accurately counting young children is an incredibly important part of the 2020 census, and we need to make sure we're doing everything we can to engage parents, teachers, doctors, and also caregivers. Everybody knows that children are our future, and we want them to have the best possible resources at their disposal. One way to do this is accurately responding to the 2020 census and counting young children. Before we begin our program today, children from Wade Park School and St. Sava Serbian Community Children's Choir have a special treat for you. Please welcome these two groups as they sing the 2020 Census Everyone Counts song.
The census counts people in homes, big and small.
You count if you're tiny.
You count if you're tall.
Because everyone counts in the U.S. of A. Everyone counts in their own special way.
The census counts everywhere, count all who live with you.
Sisters, uncles, grandmas, and your newborn babies too.
Because everyone counts in the U.S. of A. Everyone counts in their own special way.
We count all your neighbors and we count all your friends.
Until we count you,
the count will end.
In the U.S. of A, everyone counts in their own special way.
Counting is easy,
counting is fun.
Everyone counts,
and you count as well.
Cause
everyone counts
in the U.S. of A,
everyone counts
in their own special way.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Everyone counts
in the U.S. of A,
everyone counts
in their own special way.
Wasn't that amazing? Thank you. Wasn't that amazing? Let's give the kids another round of applause. Thank you, Wade Park School and St. Sava Serbian Community Choirs, for singing and sharing that song with us. Thank you. Thank you so much. The song Everyone Counts was created so children all over the country can understand what the census is and why everyone counts in their own special way. You can find Everyone Counts on our YouTube channel in English and Spanish at U.S. Census Bureau. Now, we'd like to welcome our guests to the stage today. We have with us Dr. Steve Dillingham, Director of the U.S. Census Bureau, Dr. Kirsten Ellenbogen, President and CEO of the Great Lakes Science Center. Dr. Judy Ashner, Chairperson for the Federation of Pediatric Organizations, representing the 7 major pediatric societies. August Napoli, President and CEO of the United Way of Greater Cleveland, the largest private funder of health and human services in the Greater Cleveland region. And Tracy Garrett, Assistant Vice President of Government Affairs for Sesame Street Workshop, the nonprofit organization behind Sesame Street. Thank you. We're very happy to have on stage today 3 partners who are doing great work in support of counting young children in the 2020 census. But first, let's hear from Dr. Kirsten Ellenbogen, the president and CEO of this wonderful venue, the Great Lakes Science Center.
Thank you so much. I'm Kirsten Ellenbogen, president and CEO of Great Lakes Science Center, and we are home of the NASA Glenn Visitor Center, which means we like to launch things with a countdown. So I'm gonna ask you to count down with me, and I'll start from 5, because I'm gonna share with you the top 5 reasons why Great Lakes Science Center understands the importance of the U.S. 2020 census. So, 5, all right. Every single one of Great Lakes Science Center's community partners relies on the census to do its work. from our work out in Head Start communities with early childhood programs, to our work after school in the community libraries, to our work down the road in metro schools. Not a one of them could do their work without getting the benefits from the U.S. Census. Four, the census lasts a decade. Now that is a long time, and we think about a decade often here at Great Lakes Science Center because we say our core audience are children 2 to 12 and their families. And we spend a lot of time looking at how children change during that decade from 2 to 12. Imagine a world in which those children were not supported over that entire decade. We know it is a very long time for a child, and we know then that every number counts in supporting those children over a decade. Three, 1 million children were undercounted in the last census. Now, we love numbers here at the Science Center, and that's a very concerning number. It's hard to appreciate how large a million is, especially for our young visitors today. So let me put that in a few ways for you to think about it. If you stood up here with me and just started counting, one, two, three, do you know how long it would take to get to a million? 12 days, day and night of you standing here and counting. We can think about it in terms of money, okay? Let's take a dollar bill. Dollar bill weighs a gram. $1 million bills weighs as much as my little car that's out in the parking garage. A million is a big number. We cannot undercount that many children again. The children who were undercounted were primarily 0 to 5 year olds. Now, this is the Science Center. My background's in neurology. We know that 90% of brain development happens during those critical 0 to 5 years. The greatest economic benefit, if you want to think of it in those terms, for supporting youth should be done at those 0 to 5 years. There's no greater return on our support than supporting 0 to 5 year olds. We cannot undercount the members of our community who are in the greatest need of our support. And last but not least, all right, safety. At Great Lakes Science Center, if you look around our office walls, we have a number of codes that run, right, the values and principles for this organization. And you would think here that having fun or education might be the most important thing we do. It's not. The most important thing we do at Great Lakes Science Center, and you can see from some of the equipment around us on stage, we like to blow things up, we do things on a big scale, we light fires in your hand if you come to our demonstrations, and so the number one important thing at Great Lakes Science Center is safety first. It's so critical with the census to assure our community that this is a safe process that is built around their needs. This census has been designed with our community in mind. It is safe, it is important, and it is right for them to be a part of it. So please join me in remembering these top 5 reasons as you're out in the community talking about Census 2020. And please join me in welcoming Michael back to the stage. Thank you.
Thank you, Kirsten. Thank you. Thank you for that. And yes, this is a wonderful, wonderful facility. Now I'd like to introduce we're excited to have some of our partners here today. Partners, they serve as trusted voices in the community. And we wouldn't be able to be here without their support. But before we hear from our partners, let's first hear from our director, Dr. Stephen Dillingham.
Good morning, and what a great event. It's wonderful being here in the great city of Cleveland, and what better place than the Great Lakes Science Center, right on the lake between two landmarks, the Browns Home Stadium and the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Thank all of you for being here today. What a beautiful song that we heard from such wonderful voices. They have left the stage, but I think they deserve another round of applause. Applause. And those great singers were from Wade Park, some of whom I met yesterday and heard them practicing the song, and St. Sava Serbian Community. And we want to thank both of those institutions here in the Cleveland area. I would like to thank Wade Park, as I mentioned, with grades K through 8, and their outstanding principal who's here today, Dr. Lee Buddy. We had a very educational and fun event yesterday, and it was tremendous getting in the classroom and working with the teachers and working with the students, and I kind of found my place at the kindergarten level there. We had a wonderful time, and I want to thank them for such a great invitation and being with them yesterday. We learned about a lot of the work that was being done there, and the children are the reason that we're here today. The voices of the children do matter. Those voices and children must be counted in the 2020 census. I've had the pleasure of being here in Cleveland and the Northeast Ohio on several occasions now. Last month, I was in the neighboring county, Lorain County, where at the community college, which hosted a very enthusiastic 2020 census event. We included state and local officials, community groups, members of the complete count committees. Lydia Mihalik may be here today. She's chairing the governor's Complete Count Commission and participated with us, and she was going to try to make it today, and we look forward to seeing her when she makes it. Yesterday, we learned about the terrific work of the city of Cleveland in Cuyahoga County, Complete Count Committees. We met with them, and you know, I think it's the first one that I've been to where you had the city and the county Complete Count committees meeting together. And across the nation, we now have more than 10,000 complete count committees. So that was a wonderful experience. We also appreciate having Sister Judith Ann Karam, Sisters of Charity, with us today. She was with us earlier this week at the Interfaith 2020 Census meeting at the National Cathedral in Washington, D.C. Like educators and faith-based leaders, and others, you're the trusted voices in our community. Now, today's topic, national topic, is the 2020 census, which begins to roll out. We could do that countdown again in about 3 weeks. So it did start early in remote Alaska, but it will soon be in your neighborhood. And the count of children, which represents our future, is so important. I'm so glad you've joined us to discuss this topic. The goal of the 2020 census is to count every person living in the United States. This is very important when it comes to children. It may be hard to believe, but sometimes it's more difficult to get a complete count of children. How many of you counted the ones on stage a while ago? So there are many reasons for it. It's a challenge that the Census Bureau has always faced. I look back, and people like Bill O'Hare here, who've looked at it historically, it actually goes back to 1790, and some of the reasons change in complexities, but it's something we need to address. And with our talents and energies, everyone here, I think, working together, we can address it better than ever. As I said, the causes underlying the children's undercount, and that's usually we focus on the ages up to 5, They're complex and unclear. Research does not reveal a single cause or a single solution to this historic problem. It's an unfortunate fact that the most vulnerable among us, young children, are more likely to be undercounted than any other age group. And Bill O'Hare here has written a book on it, and appreciate him being here today. And others have also contributed to this. And it really impacts different communities in different ways. It impacts the African-American community, it impacts Hispanic, it really impacts various communities that may be subject to some of those influences for that undercount. In the 2010 census, the net undercount of children under the age of 5 was estimated to exceed 4%. If the estimate is correct, that represents many children. We can and we must do better. We know that one reason we miss children is that they live in complex households. This includes living with one parent, with foster families, extended families, and when multiple families live under one roof. Undercounted children may stay in more than one home during the year, and they may not be biologically or legally related to the person that's responding to the census for that household. The head of household who's completing the census may in fact be confused at times as to what household the child should be counted with. Children also can be missed because they are homeless or they change residences around April 1st. Our data also indicates that some households which speak languages other than English may be influenced by special factors. For example, recent immigrants may leave children off their questionnaire because they're confused of its purpose. Confusion and misunderstanding of who can and who should be counted at a given address contributes to this undercount. In sum, there's general agreement that the more complex a household is, the greater the risk of a child may not be included in the completion of the census questionnaire. Such risk is significant and should be avoided. An undercount of children has implications for political representation, but more specifically for funding of things that impact them directly: health, nutrition, housing, educational programs. Sometimes they're the ones most in need, as well as community planning and the resources for schools, libraries, parks, and even playgrounds. We've been working for many years to ensure that we address the undercount of young children head on in the 2020 census. We changed the wording of our census questionnaire to help those responding on behalf of households to include children and babies. We have improved our training and the census taker practices to better solicit information about young children in the household. In our partnership and communications program, we deliver a clear message on the importance of counting all children in every household. Our educational program, called Statistics in Schools, has multiple activities and toolkits and available to the teachers and for use in the classroom. The messaging and materials explain why young children are undercounted and how to prevent it. Through our Statistics in Schools program, and I think the children were wearing their t-shirts here today, we work with local schools to educate parents about the importance of the census, including through older siblings and others. When visiting areas around the nation, census officials and myself, I deliver the message as well on the topic to school officials, teachers, young people, and children in grades K through high school, as we did in Wade Park yesterday. We're working closely with the Postal Service. Beginning in March, the letter carriers will begin delivering invitations to participate in residences where people are sometimes hard to count. We have customer service centers that would provide much needed guidance over the phone to people and families that are in those areas. But we enlist the help of many partners. We are now approaching 300,000 partners nationally. Some, including those here today, focus on helping children through organizations and local community groups, pediatrics community, and others. They help get the word out, the United Way. We appreciate all our partners, national and local. We know we can't do this alone. Many of our partners are the trusted voices. We need help in delivering the message that the 2020 census is important and safe, that it will help in continuing the great work that you are already doing as partners and associates and as engaged citizens and civic responsibilities. And as we'll be doing here today, as shown by today's event, the counting rules are not complex. If a child's time is divided between one or more than one home, count them where they stay most often. If their time is evenly divided between homes, or you don't know where they stay most often, count them where they're staying on April 1st. Count children where they live and sleep most of the time, even if their parents do not live there. The count needs to be inclusive. Count babies and children of all ages who live with you, including biological, step, adopted children, grandchildren, foster children, children in joint custody arrangements. For families who may not be fluent in English, we encourage them to respond to the questionnaire, and they can respond online or by phone. They can respond in 12 additional languages besides English, and of course we have materials to assist in 59 languages. A toll-free call can also provide the assistance in just a matter of minutes. So in conclusion, we are dedicated to making sure we get the correct count of children in the 2020 census. We are confident that with your help and support that we are so proud to receive, we can achieve this goal and get a more complete count. As I often say, the census doesn't belong to a federal agency or the federal government. It belongs to everyone, and your support is critical. You can help make a vital difference. Help us count everyone, including every child. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Director. Thank you, Director. And now we're here from some of our partners today. As the Director mentioned, partners serve our community, their community, as trusted voices and help us get a complete and accurate count of young children. We'll hear from our first partner, the Federation of Pediatric Organizations, Dr. Ashner. Welcome.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Judy Ashner, and I'm honored to be here today representing the Federation of Pediatric Organizations, or FOPO. So what is FOPO? FOPO is an umbrella organization representing the seven major societies that represent all of practicing pediatricians, pediatric researchers, pediatric educators who are training the next generation of pediatricians and pediatric subspecialists, and the leadership of pediatrics in academic departments and in children's hospitals. And although I'm up here on the stage today, I am really thrilled to be here with representatives from all seven of those organizations and the Children's Hospital organization that's here today. And I'm gonna ask my colleagues in the audience to please stand up so that everybody knows who you are. Thank you. And they're available to answer questions later after the program. So for the past 18 months, FOPO has been partnering with the Census Bureau because we know how important it is that every child counts and that every child is counted in the 2020 census. To give you an idea of why we as pediatricians who have committed our lives and our careers to the health of well-being of children realize how important this issue is, I'd like to share with you just a few of the programs that are dependent upon an accurate count of children and enormous amounts of resources that impact what happens in your homes, your communities, your counties, and your states. So for example, the Children's Health Insurance Program, or CHIP, and Medicaid that provides insurance for children with medically complex conditions depends upon an accurate count of children in your state and some of the $675 billion each year for the next 10 years that is tied to the census count goes to support these very important insurance programs for children who have medical problems. It also supports nutrition programs, so important to many of our children. SNAP and school lunch programs are, again, tied to an accurate count in the census. Census numbers determine resources that support our schools, that support education for children with disabilities, support programs like Head Start, foster care, and child care programs. And that's just a few of the programs that are so important to our children and to their futures. And it's the reason why we as pediatricians understand that this is an incredibly urgent problem and that the child undercount that we experienced in 2010, we have to do better in 2020. When you think about 10 years of funding for these important programs, that's half the childhood, half of the 20 years when you are a child. And we need to make sure that every child counts in the 2020 census. So together, the seven organizations in FOPO have been working hard to get the word out and have chosen March 25th as Every Child Counts Day. This is going to be a day of activation, of advocacy, and of mobilization. And I'm here to ask for your help. We're going to galvanize the workforce in pediatrics, in children's hospitals, in pediatric practices. We're going to be tweeting, please retweet our tweets. We're going to be doing blogs and op-eds. We're going to have posters and announcements in our hospital lobbies and in our practice waiting areas. And we're going to try to help families understand why it's important for them, for their children, for their neighborhoods and their communities, that they count every single child, even the newborn still in the hospital, on April 1st. And so I hope you'll join us on March 25th for Every Child Counts Day and partner with pediatricians across the entire United States to get the word out that children are our future, and we have to be their voice, and we have to make sure that they are counted. Thank you very much.
Hello, and good morning to everyone. Good morning. Good morning. I'm Augie Napoli, and I'm President and CEO of the United Way of Greater Cleveland. United Way organizations, as you know, across this nation, realize that hardworking families struggle to provide for their basic needs. That's why the United Way organizations here and across the country are partnering with over 15 other national organizations and countless community partners across the country to make sure that the 2020 census is fair and secure. We here in Cleveland have a crisis in our community. Approximately 51% of children live in poverty. That ranks number one in the nation, worst record in childhood poverty. And we are sadly, sadly leading the nation in that. Children and their families struggle to cover the most basic needs, food, clothing, shelter, and health care and necessary technology. The count helps families stay healthy, stay fed, and stay ready to succeed. At the United Way of Greater Cleveland, we're doing our part to make the census a priority. Last year, we've helped our U.S. Census partnership specialists connect with local organizations who serve hard-to-count populations in Cuyahoga, Geauga, and Medina counties, our corporate footprint. We serve on the Cuyahoga County Complete Count Committee and have chaired the hospital subcommittee. As a trusted provider to their patients, our hospital partners are well-positioned to promote the census with their patients. We've convened area hospitals over the last year to brainstorm, collaborate, and share resources, and we're grateful that they're all pitching in to do their part. Our 211 HelpLink provides 24/7 access to health and human services in 15 counties here in Northern Ohio. And our passionate 211 navigators, direct callers to respond to the census and providing educational resources to those who are placed on hold. There are 300,000 calls fielded by 211 HelpLink here in Cleveland, Ohio each year, and we believe that we're doing our part in that regard. Our Accountable Health Communities grant from the Department of Medicaid empowers 211 navigators to help spread the word when they meet in person with patients at the clinical sites. And our 211 data tells us, of course, that hunger is consistently in the top three of our calls. We've created a 30-second PSA to promote the importance of the census in addressing food insecurity in our community. And we're also providing local workplace campaigns with messaging to help promote the census with their employees. The count helps families access health care so families can stay healthy, show up to work and school each day throughout the year. And we do this through Medicaid, which provides coverage to 37 million children nationally, along with SCHIP, which is the state children's health insurance program, and of course, the community health centers program. 37 million children across the nation rely on public support for their physical and behavioral well-being. The count helps low-income families put food on the table, providing access to SNAP, as we heard, Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, the National School Lunch Program, after-school backpack programs, and WIC, Women, Infants, and Children, to receive infant formula and nutrition education. The count also helps children attain an education so that they can succeed in school and become self-sufficient adults through programs like Head Start's early education to enhance cognitive, social, and emotional development. In addition to that, Title I programs, the largest source of funding for public schools across the nation, is dependent on an accurate count. IDEA, Individuals with Disabilities Education Act, those grants which are awarded to states annually to support early intervention services for infants and toddlers with disabilities and their families, their preschool children ages 3 through 5, and special education for children with youth disabilities is dependent on an accurate count. The count helps children and their families access safe, affordable housing through Section 8 housing vouchers and assistance programs and low-income home energy assistance. I think that's just an overview of a broad array of programs that are dependent on an accurate count, and the people within our communities are depending on to get from Monday to Tuesday and to next week and to next year. The United Way of Greater Cleveland is proud and pleased to be a part of this effort and urge everyone to stand up and be counted. It's safe, it's secure, and it's important. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Tracy Garrett. I'm with Sesame Workshop. I want to thank Dr. Dillingham for including us today and the U.S. Census Bureau for inviting us to be part of today's event. I'm thrilled to be here to represent Sesame Workshop on such an important issue and one that goes to the very heart of what Sesame Street is really all about. We know from experts in early childhood development that one of the best things that we can do for young children to help promote their self-esteem is to help promote their self-esteem. And a critical way that we do that is to help every child know that they matter, that they are important, they are deserving of love, and they're deserving of care. It's just the same, though on a much, much larger scale with the 2020 census. Every child in every neighborhood in every community matters. They are deserving of respect, representation, and the resources that they need to prosper. They all count, and they all should be counted. Everyone here today has touched on the reasons why an accurate count is so important and why the stakes are so high this year. Of course, Sesame Workshop has always focused on the needs of preschoolers. So with an estimated 1 million undercounted children under the age of 5 in the last census, we're in a unique position to help. Our mission has always been to help kids everywhere grow smarter, stronger, and kinder. That includes helping families and communities give young children a strong and healthy start in life. When children have access to quality education, good health care, other experiences that promote their well-being, they're on a path to a bright future. So it's certainly in their best interest and ours that they be counted, especially in light of all the programs that depend on an accurate count. I think everyone here touched on all of those, but Head Start, food assistance programs, school lunch programs, the public health insurance programs, housing, foster care, these are all just to name a few. And it may surprise some of you to know that Sesame Street has gone beyond the television screen to support families in need, has always been at the foundation of our mission. Through a program called Sesame Street and Communities, we work with on-the-ground providers and partners, creating resources to help kids through the toughest of times. For example, parents struggling with addiction or a parent in prison. Many of our partners serve the very children who are the hardest to count, like those experiencing homelessness in foster care or living in poverty. And believe it or not, Sesame Street has been involved in the census for nearly 40 years. Some of you here today may remember in 1980 when Maria was hired to collect information of all the residents on Sesame Street. She explained the census in the simplest terms to Big Bird, who in turn explained it to the children and families watching the show that day. Then Big Bird helped her count everyone on Sesame Street. He and the kids at home learned about the census and got a valuable opportunity to practice their counting skills. In every census since, we've continued to do our part to spread the word, and the 2020 census seems especially critical. So we're using our voice and the beloved characters kids and families have known and trusted for over 50 years to raise awareness about the importance of counting kids and babies and to address common questions that families may have. With a little help from Elmo, Rosita and her mom, and of course the count, we're creating 6 PSAs, both in English and in Spanish, in a series of bilingual posters and materials that'll be freely available to be shared with anyone who can benefit. We focused on 4 messages that we hope that people will take away. The first message, count all kids in your family. The census brings important resources to your community. The census is fast, easy, and can now be filled out online, over the phone, or by mail. And then finally, the census is safe and the census is private. You know, what strikes us is the great irony that children who stand to benefit the most from an accurate census count are often the ones that are most likely to go uncounted. This is why we're so honored to work through the United States Census Bureau alongside organizations like the Federation of Pediatric Organizations, the United Way, the Ad Council, the American Academy of Pediatrics, and so many others at the local and state levels across the country to reverse the equation and do all that we can together to make sure that every child counts. And now it's my privilege to show you the first look at one of our PSAs. We could roll the PSA.
Ah, the census, my favorite time of the decade.
Census, what's that?
Oh, it is a special time when we count each person in every home in all the neighborhoods across the country. One monster of Sesame Street.
Oh, do kids count?
Of course, everyone in your home counts, especially little kids and babies. Oh. One, two. Two little kids.
But why do we count everyone?
Ah, great question. Counting everyone in your home helps support your neighborhood for the next 10 years by funding things like schools, hospitals, and buses. So count yourself and everyone in your home. In 10 minutes, you can complete the census by calling or going online or return your form by mail.
It's easy, secure, and most important, it's totally private.
Make your family count!
This year, make sure every child counts. Visit 2020census.gov.
We have some really good writers and producers, so I'm very grateful that they put that together. Just to share, then these are live now. For a closer look at our PSAs and our full suite of materials, you can find them at www.sesameworkshop.org/2020census. Broadcasters will be able to access them through Extreme Reach, the Ad Council's PSA Central, or WNET's Wavelink platform for public broadcasters. And again, a thank you to Dr. Ellingham and the Census Bureau for including us today. And a special thank you for the Federation of Pediatric Organizations for their announcement, and to the United Way, and to the Great Lakes Science Center for such an amazing location. So I appreciate it, and we look forward to working with all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you all. Wasn't that PSA wonderful? As you can see, this is the moment. The 2020 census is here. And remember, in just a few weeks, you'll have a chance to shape your future and the future of young children. I'd like to thank everyone for being here today for the 2020 Census Counting Young Children Family Festival at the Great Lakes Science Center. As well, I'd like to give a big thank you to our speakers. We hope you were all inspired and will become partners if you haven't already. You can visit 2020census.gov for more information. Thank you, and remember, everyone counts.